Hello and welcome to the 7 o'clock news from Bahrain International. I'm Sarah Lebrick. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa left the Kingdom of Bahrain on a visit to Egypt to hold meetings and discussions with Egyptian President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi. The meetings will include topics on the historic relations between the two countries and ways to further bolster these relations, in addition to regional and international topics of common concern. His Majesty was bid farewell by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Premier Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa patronized the 12th edition of Bahrain First Festival, organized by the Ministry of Education at Bahrain National Stadium, which is celebrating the centennial of formal education in Bahrain upon the arrival of His Majesty's motorcade. His Majesty was received by the Minister of Education, Dr. Majid Al-Naimi, who presented to His Majesty the education ministers of Arab countries, general managers of a number of regional and international education organizations, as well as a representative of the Arab League, who attended the festival upon the invitation of His Majesty the King to participate in the celebrations.
لكثير من الشوق يرحب أبناء وبنات طالبات مملكة البحرين بقدوم حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك المفدى حفظه الله ورعاه وتشريفه الكبير لهذا الحفل. بأعلى الصوت يرددون طلبة وطالبات مملكة البحرين: عاش الملك، عاش الملك. هذه الكلمات التي لطالما رددها طلبة وطالبات مملكة البحرين عبر أعوام فاقت العشر، وهم يصرخون ويهتفون بأعلى صوت: عاش الملك، عاش الملك،
عاش عاش بوسلمان. احنا جيل بوسلمان. عاش الملك، عاش الملك، عاش عاش بوسلمان. احنا جيل بوسلمان. عاش الملك، عاش الملك، عاش عاش بوسلمان، عاش الملك، عاش الملك، عاش عاش بوسلمان. احنا جيل بوسلمان. عاش الملك، عاش الملك، عاش عاش بوسلمان. احنا جيل بوسلمان. عاش الملك، عاش الملك، عاش عاش بوسلمان. عاش الملك، عاش الملك.
Thank you.
The ceremony began with the national anthem. Then a student recited verses from the Holy Quran.
إن خير ما نبدأ به حفلنا هذا آيات عطيرة من الذكر الحكيم يتلوها على مسامعكم القارئ عبد الرحمن المهيدل من مدرسة الإمام الغزالي الإعدادية للبنين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الرحمن علم القرآن خلق الإنسان علمه البيان الشمس والقمر بحسبان والنجم والشجر يسجدان والسماء رفعها ووضع الميزان صدق الله العظيم.
كلمة سعادة وزير التربية والتعليم بهذه المناسبة.
Following that, the Minister of Education delivered a speech in which he expressed thanks and gratitude to His Majesty the King for patronizing the event, adding that His Majesty's patronage is an appreciation of the role of the educational march in the development of human beings. He stated that this year's celebration will be remembered for generations as it brings together national, historic, and Arab dimensions. The minister noted that Bahrain, as a result of the support of His Majesty, has made many remarkable results in international reports on education and human development. He added that the ministry implemented the directives of His Majesty on enhancing citizenship education and documenting the efforts of the people of Bahrain and their contributions to their country.
لحضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة عاهل البلاد المفدى.
His Majesty the King delivered a speech on the occasion.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الأساتذة الأفاضل أولياء الأمور الكرام أبنائي وبناتي الطلاب والطالبات الأعزاء السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نرحب بداية بضيوفنا الكرام من وزراء ومسؤولين بحقل التربية والتعليم في وطننا العربي الذين نسعد بحضورهم بداية احتفالات موسم أفراحنا الوطنية هذا العام بمناسبة الذكرى المئوية لانطلاق التعليم النظامي، متمنين لمؤتمرهم الذي تستضيفه البحرين بالتزامن مع هذه المناسبة الوطنية الهامة كل توفيق ونجاح والوصول إلى قرارات نوعية تسهم في تسليح أجيالنا بعتاد المستقبل استعداداً لتحولاته المتسارعة نحو الاقتصاد المعرفي والرقمي وبما يحقق النماء والرخاء المستحق لشعوبنا العربية. وبكل محبة وفخر أحيي أبنائي وبناتي في هذا التجمع الطلابي السنوي الذي نحرص على مشاركتهم أفراحا بما يقدمونه من لوحات فنية تعبر عن تقديرهم وحبهم للوطن العزيز الذي يسمو بهم ويحمي مصالحهم على طريق مستقبلهم الواعد بإذن الله تعالى. ومن منطلق اعتزازنا الكبير بإسهامات كل من حمل رسالة التعليم السامية من رجالنا ونسائنا الكرام، فقد وجهنا بتوثيق شامل لمسيرة التعليم الوطنية تخليداً لذكراها المئوية، فهي ذكرى تاريخية عزيزة جعلت من بلادنا مركزاً للإشعاع الحضاري والتنوير المعرفي والبناء المدني، وصولاً لنموذجنا الوطني الحي بتراثه الإنساني العريق وبقدرته على العمل والإنتاج في كافة المجالات. وختاماً لا يفوتنا أن نبارك لكم النتائج المتميزة التي حققتها مملكة البحرين مؤخراً في عدد من المحافل والتقارير الدولية، ويعود فضل ذلك من بعد الله للجهود الحثيثة والمتواصلة لكوادرنا التعليمية واجتهاد طلبتنا وطالباتنا وحرصهم جميعاً على رفع راية بلادنا عالية. كما يسعدنا تقديراً منا لأبنائنا وبناتنا أن يكون يوم قد إجازة لهم، وكل عام وأنتم بخير.
عاش الملك، عاش الملك، عاش عاش بو سلمان.
The ministry's members then presented a commemorative gift to His Majesty the King, which is an artwork made by student Ghadir Ali. After that, several performances were held celebrating the centennial of formal education in Bahrain, which included musical numbers and theatrical performances.
أهلا أهلا بالأب الحاني، أهلا براعي العلم، أهلا بباني نهضة بلادي، جلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة حفظه الله ورعاه. جئناك يا سيدي من كل الحضارات ومن كل الأزمنة التي مرت فوق ثرى هذه الأرض الطهور، أرض الخلود، لنقول لمقامكم السامي بكل اللغات، بالشعر حيناً وبالحب أحياناً، يا مولاي أنتم خير من حمل أمانة العلم وأديتم حقها على أكمل وجه.
بحر، بحر من البحرين تحتك قد جرى عشقاً، وبحر بالحنين تفجرا، ملك القلوب، ملك القلوب تجذرا.
جئناك من كل العصور فهاكها تلك الأمانة والربيع الأخضر. أمجادنا، أمجادنا بيديك خير أمانة، والورد حتما، حتما في الجناين أزهارا.
اسمح لي يا مولاي أن أتنقل عبر الأزمنة في رحلة أمر فيها على تاريخ. أرض الخلود منتشياً عبير التعليم في وطن البحرين الحديث منذ أن أرسى أجدادك نهضة التعليم وصولاً إلى إنجازاتك التي نفاخر العالم بها.
قامت على هذه الجزيرة ملأت الدنيا حباً وسلاماً. انقشوا دلمون أرض مقدسة، دلمون أرض طهور. على دلمون لا ينعق الغراب ولا يفترس الأسد الحمل، لا يشتكي الرجل من الشيخوخة ولا المرأة تصبح عجوزا. دلمون أرض مباركة، هي البحرين أرض الحضارات،
هي البحرين أرض الحضارات.
يا سيدي
His Majesty the King then was bid farewell. The Minister of Education expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for his directive to document the Comprehensive Education March of Bahrain to mark the centennial anniversary. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa received the President of the Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities, Sheikh Hamay bint Mohammed Al Khalifa, at Ghadibiyah Palace. His Royal Highness highlighted the Kingdom's commitment to supporting its culture and heritage sectors, noting they represent a vital component of Bahrain's rich national identity. He emphasized the importance of continuing to promote Bahrain's historical legacy, which stands as a testimony to the many achievements that have contributed to the Kingdom's continued development in line with the vision of His Majesty the King. Sheikh Hamay presented to His Royal Highness a number of her editorial publications. His Royal Highness wished Sheikh Hamay continued success in promoting Bahrain's culture and antiquities. Sheikh Hamay expressed gratitude for the opportunity to meet with His Royal Highness, noting His Royal Highness's continued support to BACA's efforts in preserving the Kingdom's cultural heritage. The Minister of Finance and National Economy, Sheikh Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, also attended the meeting. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa held his weekly majlis at Rafah Palace. Members of the royal family, senior government officials, members of the Shura Council and Council of Representatives, members of municipal councils, religious and community leaders, journalists and diplomats attended the majlis. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince welcomed the broad range of visitors at the weekly majlis, which demonstrates Bahrain's commitment to rooted traditions and values that are underpinned by His Majesty's aspirations to maintain a strong bond amongst Bahrain's society. The majlis visitors extended their appreciation and gratitude to His Royal Highness for hosting the majlis and emphasized the important role His Royal Highness plays in advancing sustainable development to guarantee prosperity and opportunity for the people of Bahrain.
Thank you.
His Majesty the King's representative for charity work and youth affairs, national security advisor and chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, chaired the council's meeting in the presence of the first deputy president of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and president of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, the council's second deputy chairman, Sheikh Isa bin Rashid Al Khalifa, the council's head of the coordination, implementation and follow-up committee, Sheikh Faisal bin Rashid Al Khalifa, and a number of council members. His Highness Sheikh Nasser expressed appreciation to His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa's support of the youth and sports movement and athletes, which contributed to making a number of achievements. His Highness noted that youth and sports movements have witnessed a development in various periods. He hailed the efforts of His Highness Sheikh Khalid in leading the Olympic Committee and for the Kingdom's achievements, and His Highness Sheikh Faisal's keenness to follow up on the projects and the youth and sports sectors. Sheikh Nasser directed to study the establishment of a company to manage neighborhood fields in cooperation with the private sector. His Highness Sheikh Faisal reviewed the integration of sports facilities in the Kingdom, where it was agreed to take the necessary arrangements for the study of government sports facilities in a 10-year plan to build schools in cooperation with the Ministry of Works, Municipalities Affairs and Urban Planning, the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Finance and National Economy. He also reviewed the results of the committee, which led to the payment of the first installment of the dues of players, administrators and technicians, the establishment of a sports fund, the integration of sports facilities in Bahrain and a project to establish 100 stadiums, in addition to activating the supervision of the Ministry of Youth and Sports Authorities. His Highness Sheikh Nasser hailed the agreement between the Ministry of Youth and Sports and Temkin regarding national clubs. He affirmed that the agreement will help the clubs financially and enhance competitiveness. The agreement was signed between the Minister of Youth and Sports Affairs, Ayman Al-Mu'ayyad, and CEO of Temkin, Dr. Ibrahim Janahi. The agreement aims to launch an electronic system to support institutions, restructuring the evaluation system of the national clubs, abide by rules and regulations, and create comprehensive sports teams. The agreement will also develop the national club's experience, develop the information technology system, activate an integrated control panel for the management of the electronic system, introduce a new mechanism for payment by automating the procedures, in addition to displaying all information related to the project via an integrated page. The first deputy president of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and chairman of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received presidents of federations who made numerous achievements. His Highness hailed their achievements, which are added to the series of Bahrain's 2019 accomplishments. His Highness praised the achievements of the sports sector in the kingdom and praised the support of His Majesty the King in this regard, and said that His Majesty's support enhanced the kingdom's achievements. His Highness praised the efforts of all who contributed to these achievements and raise the status of the kingdom. The first deputy president of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports, president of Bahrain Olympic Committee and president of the High Organizing Committee of 2019, Brave, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Hamad Al Khalifa, visited Khalifa Sports City Stadium, in which the Brave events will take place. Upon arrival, His Highness was received by the president of Bahrain Mixed Martial Arts Federation, the BMMAF, and president of Brave Executive Committee, Muhammad Ali Gambar, and the advisor of Bahrain Olympic Committee, president and president of Brave Organization, Muhammad Shahid, president of International Mixed Martial Arts Federation, the IMMAF, K Kareth Brown and IMMAF CEO Denise White, as well as a number of executive committee members and chairmen of the working committees. Zaina Sheikh Khaled affirmed that Brave International Combat Week reflects the kingdom's success in organizing the largest sports event held on its land. His Highness listened to a briefing on the committee's preparations according to the plan developed by the High Committee. His Highness Sheikh Khaled stated that the goal is to build on the successes of the kingdom in organizing various sporting events, expressing appreciation for the efforts exerted by the executive committee and work committees in implementing a work plan for the event's preparations. The Deputy Prime Minister and President of the Supreme Council for the Development of Education and Training, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, received, in the presence of the Minister of Education, Dr. Majid bin Ali Naimi, the ministers and heads of delegations participating in the 11th Annual Education Conference hosted by the Kingdom, in line with the celebrations of the centennial of formal education in Bahrain. His Highness affirmed the importance of holding the conference, which focuses on the importance of education and its role in the comprehensive development in the Arab world and the future of coming generations. He asserted the importance of exchanging educational experiences and expertise between Arab countries, noting the role of the home and the community in the educational process. For their part, the Arab ministers expressed pleasure in participating in the conference and appreciation for the generous hospitality, hailing the kingdom's educational achievements and wishing it further growth and prosperity. The BDF Commander-in-Chief Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa visited the U.S. Maritime Support Unit headquarters and inaugurated the International Marine Security Building in the presence of the Minister of Defense Affairs, Lieutenant General Abdullah bin Hassan Naimi, and Naval Captain His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. The BDF Commander-in-Chief then met with the Commander of the U.S. Naval Forces Central Command and Commander of the 5th Fleet, James Malloy, and the Field Marshal praised his role in performing his tasks and duties. He praised the strong ties between Bahrain and the U.S. and the cooperation witnessed at all levels, especially the military, marine, and defense fields. He praised the joint efforts to combat terrorism and the threats that target maritime security, in addition to the efforts that aim at achieving further security and stability in the Gulf and the region. The BDF Commander-in-Chief then toured the building and was briefed on the developed systems and equipment. He was also briefed on duties of the building and the stages of work it follows in order to enhance maritime security and ensure freedom of maritime navigation and to address the various challenges and threats surrounding the region. The inauguration ceremony was attended by the UAE Ambassador to the Kingdom, His Highness Sheikh Sultan bin Hamdan bin Zayed Al Nahyan, the U.S. Ambassador to the Kingdom, Justin Sabrell, the U.K. Ambassador to the Kingdom, Rudy Dramond, and Commander of the Naval Forces and the Armed Forces in Saudi Arabia, Lieutenant General Fahd bin Abdullah Al-Ghafeli, senior officers and officials. An official parliamentarian discussion session was held in the Moroccan capital Rabat, chaired by the Speaker of the Representatives Council, Fawzia bint Abdallah Zeynal, and her Moroccan counterpart, Sayyid Al Habib Al Maliki, as part of the official visits conducted by Zeynal and her accompanying delegation to Morocco to bolster cooperation, utilizing the Moroccan parliamentary experience and exchanging points of view on affairs of joint interest. Zeynal affirmed that the directives of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa supported joint Arab parliamentary work to activate fraternal relations and bolster comprehensive development cooperation. She noted that the outstanding relations between Bahrain and Morocco are historic and strategic, led by His Majesty the King and the Moroccan monarch, His Majesty King Mohammed VI. She highlighted the deep-rooted fraternal relations between Bahrain and Morocco, asserting the keenness on activating a parliamentarian cooperation between the two countries. During the meeting, a memorandum of understanding between the Bahraini and Moroccan Representatives Councils has been signed to activate the role of the friendship committees and achieve bilateral cooperation. For his part, the Moroccan Representatives Council president asserted the deep-rooted joint Bahraini-Moroccan relations and his country's support to Bahrain in various circumstances, highlighting the leading model of bilateral relations. Under the patronage of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa, the Kingdom of Bahrain hosts the 11th Conference of Arab Ministers of Education, organized by the Arab League Educational, Cultural and Scientific Organization, ALEXO, in cooperation with the Ministry of Education and in the presence of Arab ministers, senior officials, directors and representatives of a number of regional and international education organizations, and a representative of the Secretariat General of the Arab League. The Minister of Education delivered a speech in which he welcomed the participants in the conference, which coincides with the kingdom's celebration of his educational centennial. He conveyed the greetings and appreciation of His Majesty the King, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, and their wishes for their conference to enhance the Arab Education March. The minister expressed thanks to the efforts of the Education Minister of Jordan, which hosted the previous conference, wishing the new Director General of ALEXO, Mohammed Amer, a success. Al-Naimi also affirmed that joint Arab education action will enhance efforts that aim to achieve the fourth Sustainable Development Goal, which is the main focus of the conference, adding that Bahrain has made great strides towards this goal. The Malaysian King, His Majesty Sultan Abdullah bin Sultan Ahmed Shah, received today at the Malaysian capital the President of the Asian Football Federation and First Deputy of the International Football Federation, Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim Al Khalifa, on the sidelines of the celebration regarding granting His Majesty the Sultan and the Asian Diamond Award. Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim conveyed the greetings of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa to the Malaysian King. The Malaysian King welcomed Sheikh Salman and wished him abundant health and happiness, and for Bahrain further progress and prosperity. Sheikh Salman bin Ibrahim praised the contributions of the Malaysian King in serving the Asian football for 3 decades. He expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty for his efforts and contributions throughout the years. Sheikh Salman also hailed His Majesty's role in serving both the Asian and international federations and making numerous achievements, wishing him further success.